we all know and love.
Right.
But there's a group of players that are just below the glass ceiling.
Like, literally,
and are
right there.
Just fighting to break through. Hex is probably the closest to getting out.
Him and just the Flippers boys in general.
The Flippers crew, they come and they make a presence. I had to fight one of them just earlier. It was a struggle. I had to... Oh.
Oh, man.
And now Hex probably has the best placements out of the Flippers crew. And against a returning Master Raven, I'd give him just as good a shot as anyone. Like,
no, absolutely.
He's definitely got a fighter's chance here.
And speaking of Master Raven, after he came back from his break, man, he feels like he has been playing the best that he's ever played at the game. Like,
really?
He says that his mind was refreshed and that he has a new, you know, mindset towards the game. So we'll see how, you know, that'll fare.
Oh, boy.
Somebody like Hex.
Hex actually does like this stage to begin with, and he was able to get it. And he's just going to tee off on that shield to begin.
Oh, man. That was already almost a broken shield, my god. That
I was going to say, 5 seconds in, and Master Raven's shield no longer exists.
No. You can't afford the shield for the rest of the match right there.
No. Now, one thing that Hex actually also he does well is his use of jab cancels with Yoshi, which sounds strange. I mean, of course, like everyone knows about the bread and butter jab to imagination.
Yeah.
But Hex at mid percentages can actually, he'll do single jab over and over again on someone's shield.
I've seen it, yeah.
And he actually can do the B reverse down B, which is weird. So, like, he's facing one way and it comes out the other way.
Right.
So he's got like that veil of unpredictability.
No, absolutely. Like, I've played him a couple of times and I'm always like, man, how do you even do this? But right now,
Master Raven running the old Dark Donald tag.
Dark Donald.
Return of the god himself. Salty Bets.
Salty Bets. Shout out to Salty Bets.
But Hex has got to be really careful, because one thing he also does, he will unfortunately sometimes telegraph his landings.
Yes.
And he has to be very careful that he doesn't fall into an air dodge read.
Yeah, he's told me a couple of times that there are times where when he's in the air, nice up there for Master
really,
by the way.
Great
that,
job to close that out.
Yeah, he just tends to autopilot, so he just kind of goes with the flow, sort of thing. It's it's a bit flow chart, but at the same time, like, he does it really well.
Like, definitely. Now he's got to play from behind, and that's never good against Sheik. This is a character. She's best for a reason. She can take small leads like this and snowball them.
No, yeah, that's the thing about Sheik. She, you know, man, when she gets the lead...
Great weight there by Hex. Sorry about that.
No, it's okay. No, that was a fantastic read. The thing about Sheik is that when she has the lead on you, it's so hard to take it back from her, because if she doesn't want you in, man...
She will be out of there.
She'll keep you out. And with the mobility that occurs, she'll run away from you if necessary.
Mm-hmm. And we're seeing a fine display of that right now. Only right now Master Raven deciding to push to stay. That's going to bug Hex, because this is normally the story with him against Sheik. It's close, and then it gets away, or it's close to the end, and it gets away. At some point, he's in there, and it fades away.
Right. No, and now he's going final destination. I feel like maybe he's not... He doesn't really like the platforms against, you know, Master Raven. Master Raven using, you know, platforms.
Yeah,
to
he definitely used the platforms to lock down Hex towards the end. But one thing that this is going to disadvantage Hex in a little bit is it's also going to limit his landing options. And because he already has that air dodge habit,
that's true.
It's going to open up opportunities for Master Raven to seal up stocks if he's correct of smash.
Well, we'll see how this will go right now.
They're just boxing.
Yeah.
They are duking it out. And that's something. He's got to be really careful with some of the eggs, but I still would like to see more eggs. Like, more mid to long range eggs. Once he breaks mid range, abandon the eggs.
no more eggs, please.
Stop it. Because Sheik has every resource to get in there. No issue.
Do they just go through eggs? Do they just beat him out?
No. But in my strange experiences with eggs, I've actually fared an egg before.
Wow. That's kind of funny.
I was disturbed. Alright, this is trouble.
And right now, man, Master Raven putting on a lot of pressure on Hex.
Master Raven has been putting on a clinic. Oh, he didn't know about the preemptive punish. The auto cancel vanish.
That is the thing.
Oh. Hex having the hardest time getting down to the ground. Watch the air dodge.
He's all over him. Look at that. But the moment he touches the ground, Master Raven is already there.
He's there. He's either got the needles flowing like this, or just good luck. Now he's trying to mix in grenades. Only imagine how that's gonna go. Oh boy. Any damage is good damage.
Oh man.
Oh. Up air.
Oh, Hex had something there going.
He still has his double jump, right? Uh-oh. Goodness. He went for the high vanish.
Trying to go for the hardest beats. Oh, I thought that was gonna be an up air. That
got the air dodge, but misses on the up air. But now Hex is at that percent where he doesn't have to worry about things really leading into true kills.
Yeah.
No, Master absolutely. Raven has to also now force a kill. So,
yeah, there is a certain percent. Like, after a certain point, Sheik does struggle a lot more to get kills because she can't do the down throw 50-50.
Yeah, and fair and back air, they're not going to get the job done as Yoshi's traveling across the stage, and you can react to bouncing fish.
Yeah. Especially considering the fact that Yoshi is very heavy, so a forward air won't kill until much later. Yeah.
Going across the stage again, but at the same time, I think he's... Oh, I was going to say he didn't have his jump, and I think when he hit him with that last back air, he used his last egg, too, so eggs were going to send him straight down. So now, back in the situation of the last game.
Oh, nice.
Trying to force kills.
He hasn't been using his command grab either.
Yeah, he normally is very loose with his command grab. He will throw it, but this game, something's up.
Oh, yeah. Like, that was the first time he ever used it. He landed,
in the set, actually.
But at the same time, I just feel Master Raven is moving way too much, so he's having...
Yeah, no, he's putting on a clinic of, this is how you play Sheik against Yoshi. Yeah. If Yoshi is doing this, Sheik, by chance, should be doing this.
Yeah.
if you're in the egg, you break out it with Nair.
Yeah. If this happens, you do this. And
it's been working very well. Oh my goodness.
Oh my God.
Just those, like, and even if they're not hard hits, it's damage racking up towards killing Yoshi later.
Yeah.
The more Master Raven hits Yoshi, it's just no benefit for Hex right now. This is not going well
it's
at all.
It's not going well, especially considering Master Raven still has a stock lead. Hex has to get the stock right now.
Yeah, and Master Raven, he's not the player. He's not the easiest player to cheese out either.
No, yeah, absolutely. I would know.
Alright, he's finally starting to at least throw the command grab out there a little more, but is it a case of too little too late?
Well, I still feel like if Hex were to get the stock right now...
That's trouble.
Well, that's... Wow.
The air dodge read and 150 rage, Sheik. People forget, up air will still kill. It will still get the job done. It will still get the job done.
Yeah, and tap dancing on Yoshi's face, and that's going to take the stock right away.
So...
That was a very convincing...
That was, win. Yeah, that was a decisive 2-0. I've seen much better showings from Hex.
Yeah.
I...